kingdom of heaven is like a pearl, is like a buried treasure. And those that find it are filled with joy. And they literally sell everything they have and receive that treasure, that gift, that pearl. It's a pearl of life, if you will. Praying over the gospel, I found myself thinking about moments when the joy of the Lord touches us. And when we get a glimpse of the kingdom of heaven, when we get a glimpse of Jesus really speaking to us. So, mamas and daddies out there, when you've heard, when you've held your newborn child for the very first time, that's joy. Or when we had a moment in which we really do feel the love of God. It could be a sunrise or a sunset. It's one of those where you want to take a picture and say, wow, God, I'd like to preserve this. Those are special, special moments. Or moments when you're in reconciliation to receive forgiveness. And all of a sudden you realize that God has really forgiven you. Those are kingdom of heaven moments. Those are love of God. Those are moments when you really want to sell everything and stay there and have that cherished close to our hearts. And so that becomes part of the question for each of us. Is the joy of the kingdom of heaven really in our lives? Or do we find the stuff of life overcoming the kingdom of heaven, the kingdom of God's love, if you will, in a very special way, in our lives, getting overwhelmed by the stuff of life, the difficulties of life, the problems of life? I had a friend, I'll call him Bob, not his real name, and he loved his family, but he was working to keep his business going, and he was putting in 12, 14 hours a day, and he barely saw his family at all. And as time went by, the pressure of the business, he had a heart attack. And it was one of those that knocked him off his seat completely. And he was really in and out of consciousness. And after surgery, he found himself kind of sensing around him some figures, but they were shadowy figures. He couldn't figure out who they were at all. He didn't know. And after he finally came to consciousness, he realized that it was his wife and his children that had been standing around his bed the whole time he was ill. That moment, he told me, changed his life. And he realized that the kingdom of heaven was standing right around him. He realized that it wasn't in his work that he was going to really find fulfillment in God's love. It was with his family. And so he made a commitment to his family to be with them, which he did. And one of the things that happened for him, and it was a blessing for the family too, is as he loved them, it began to change them. And they found themselves changed in his presence with his change of life. And the teenage son spent a little more time at home. The youngest daughter didn't scream all day because she was missing her daddy. It was a moment of grace. That's a kingdom of heaven moment. Those happen to every single one of us. And we come back to the question, is the joy of heaven really in our lives? Or is the stuff of life blurring the joy of heaven in our lives? It's really meant to be a part of us. So when people meet us, they meet the joy of heaven. They meet the risen Lord Jesus. They meet the one who has won the victory, Jesus our Lord. It's a moment of faith. As we continue the gospel, we heard there's also another parable about the net, the fishing net, and those that are gathered into the fishing net, and those that are thrown away. It really does become a moment for us to realize there is a judgment. And how we hold the kingdom of heaven in our hearts, how we witness to the kingdom of heaven, means a lot. The other side of this just as Bob's family changed because of the change that was activated within him, the grace of God touching him, the realization that the kingdom of heaven was standing around him. I remember one family, they shared a real simple story. The dad had just woken up. The mom of the house was downstairs cooking breakfast. And as she cooked breakfast, the little ones, two little girls, one older, one younger, were watching her. And she finally turned to them and said, "Go tell Daddy that breakfast is ready." And as the two of them ran upstairs, of course, the older one ran faster, got upstairs faster, and got to Daddy and leaped in his lap, hugged his neck and said, "Daddy, Mommy says breakfast is ready." And then she turned and looked at her little sister who was coming into the room in tears because she had missed the moment. And as she came and rushing up to Daddy, as Daddy opened his arms to her, the little sister simply said, and none of our children would do this, but the little sister said, "There's no more Daddy left. I have all of him." Now kids, you wouldn't do that. But the little daughter came flying up, leaped also into Daddy's lap and said, "That's okay, because Daddy has all of me." Does our God have all of us? All of us, completely. Our hearts, our minds, our souls, our being. Because that's in the end what the great treasure is about. And the kingdom of God is within us to be shared. Let's ask for that grace of the kingdom of God's love to truly envelop our lives during this Eucharist.